the marathon, 26.2 miles, 42.1 kilometers. Since 1896, this premier distance event has been the source of incredible joy and deep suffering to countless runners throughout the world, as it requires exceptional endurance and fierce focus just to finish. Like many distance running events, the marathon has been completely dominated by East Africans. Out of the 25 fastest athletes to ever run this distance, all 25 of them were born in either Kenya or Ethiopia. While it certainly helps to have good natural speed for the marathon, endurance is far and away the most crucial characteristic to achieve success. On September 16, 2018, Kenyan runner Eliud Kipchoge set the current world record with a time of 2 hours, 1 minute, and 39 seconds. This time slashed over 1 minute off the previous record set by fellow Kenyan Dennis Kimeto back in 2014. This time averages out to 4 minutes and 38.3 seconds per mile, or 2 minutes and 52.9 seconds per kilometer, which is simply amazing. When you watch Kipchoge run, it's quite obvious that endurance is his best running quality. Combined with his smooth stride and superior running economy, Kipchoge's physical makeup is almost ideally suited for the marathon. Over the past 100 years, marathon times have dropped dramatically, with a total net improvement of almost 1 hour. In 1908, Johnny Hayes from the United States ran a time of 2 hours, 55 minutes, and 18 seconds. And while this time is certainly a solid time, even by today's standards, he would have lost to Eliud Kipchoge by a whopping 53 minutes and 39 seconds. This means that Kipchoge would have beaten Hayes by approximately 8 miles, or 13 kilometers. Obviously, there have been drastic improvements in distance running over this past century as training, nutrition, and overall running knowledge have gotten better. But what does the world record history for the marathon look like? And who were the athletes to make such enormous leaps on the record over the past 100 years? Between 1908 and 1920, the world record was broken a total of 10 times, with Hannes Kolomainen from Finland running a time of 2 hours, 32 minutes, and 35 seconds on August 22, 1920. In just 12 short years, the record had already been improved by over 20 minutes. However, as each decade progressed, the margin for improvement would become smaller and smaller. From 1920 to 1930, the record was improved by only 6 minutes, and following this decade, from 1930 to 1940, the record dropped by less than 1 minute. Although this record became increasingly difficult to beat, there have been a few special athletes throughout the years that have shattered all expectations. In the early 1950s, the legendary runner Jim Peters from Great Britain set 4 consecutive world records as he lowered the record mark to an impressive time of 2 hours, 17 minutes, and 39 seconds. Along with these new world records, Peters became the very first athlete to ever run under 2 hours and 20 minutes. In the 1954 British Commonwealth Games, Peters entered the stadium a full 17 minutes ahead of the next competitor, and it's also documented that he was a full 10 minutes ahead of his own world record pace. Although he was scheduled to be the first human to ever break the 2 hour and 10 minute barrier, Peters collapsed with less than 400 meters to run, and he sadly never finished the race. Suffering from massive fatigue and extreme dehydration, Peters later said, "I was lucky not to have died that day." Just 6 years after Peters' reign of dominance, a thin and very efficient runner from Ethiopia emerged as the new face of marathon greatness. At the 1960 Olympics in Rome, Abibi Bekele won the gold medal with a new world record time of 2 hours, 15 minutes, and 16 seconds, and he managed to break this world record without shoes. This breakthrough was beyond phenomenal, since Bekele is the only athlete in recorded history to break the marathon world record on his bare feet. Following this record performance, Bekele defended his gold medal in the 1964 Tokyo Olympics, again breaking the world record with a time of 2 hours, 12 minutes, and 11 seconds. Except this time, he made sure to wear shoes for his world record performance. Previously, I experimented with just how difficult it is to run barefoot at this pace, and it truly does showcase just how impressive Bekele's record was. Since Bekele's fantastic record in 1964, the world record has been broken a total of 21 times, with the largest margin of improvement coming from Derek Clayton of Australia in 1967, who broke the previous world record by over 2 minutes. Over the past 10 years or so, we've seen a massive increase in marathon popularity. Along with Kipchoge's official marathon world record back in 2018, he also became the first human in history to break the 2-hour mark as he ran a time of 1 hour, 59 minutes, and 40 seconds at the INEOS 159 Challenge on October 12, 2019. Although this time is not considered an official world record, Kipchoge's performance was a landmark moment for marathon racing, as he averaged 4 minutes and 33.8 seconds per mile, or 2 minutes 50.1 seconds per kilometer. This world record history shows the unbelievable potential that exists among runners throughout the world. Whenever a barrier seems impossible, someone always comes along that flips the marathon world upside down. Whether it be Jim Peters, Abibi Bakila, Paul Turgot, or Eliud Kipchoge, the marathon world record is always on someone's radar. But what does it feel like to run these marathon times? And how does it feel to run just one lap at each of these speeds? To better understand what it feels like to run these times, I put together a track workout specifically designed to see how the world record in the marathon has progressed over the years. For this workout, we'll be doing 12 400 meter repeats, and for each rep, we'll be taking one world record from each decade, starting with the very first record in 1908 and ending with the current world record of Eliud Kipchoge. As you can see, each lap will get progressively faster, and in a similar fashion, the pain will also increase as each lap goes on. Starting with Johnny Hayes, our target lap is 1 minute 39.7 seconds. This pace was quite easy, as Hayes only averaged 6 minutes and 41 seconds per mile. At this pace, I was actually struggling not to run too fast, as I was already preparing for the faster paces to follow. 136.8. Up next is Harry Green, and for this rep, we have to hit 1 minute 30.02 seconds. Again, this pace was quite easy, but as the workout continued, each repetition became more and more of a challenge. Through the halfway point, the pace honestly wasn't too difficult, but as I jumped into the 1960s world record of Abibi Bakila, the pace increased dramatically. For this repetition, I had to run a lap in 1 minute 15.18 seconds. At this pace, I was running right around 5 minutes per mile. I noticed then that I was starting to sweat much more heavily, and between reps, it was becoming more and more difficult to catch my breath. For my 8th repetition, I had to run a time of 1 minute 13.56 seconds, which was the pace run by Ron Hill in 1970. This pace is the equivalent to a 4:55 mile, or a 3 minute and 3 second kilometer. This interval was the first time where I really came to appreciate just how fast these athletes really are, and it's mind-boggling to think that they ran this pace for a full marathon. At this point, I was breathing much harder, and I was sweating much more, but I still had 4 intervals left to run. I'm gonna go ahead and tell you, the last 4 repetitions were definitely the hardest. This only makes sense because I was running much faster than the previous reps, but running the actual pace is a completely different ballgame.
People are fast, man. People are really fast. I cannot imagine running that fast for a whole marathon, let alone a 5K, but then again, there's like a lot of people watching this that are like, bro, come on, that's easy. Oh yeah? Well, you come out and do it. You come out, I'm just kidding, that's mean.
Wait, it's funny though.
Again, I challenge you all, pick one world record for each decade. The only rule is you have to use the very first one and the most recent one. So shout out to Kipchoge. Gonna kick my ass again very soon.
For my 10th 400 meter interval, I had to run a time of 1 minute 11.49 seconds, which is the equivalent to a 4 minute and 47 second mile. For my 11th rep, I had to run a time of 1 minute 10.5 seconds, which was the pace accomplished by the great Haile Gebrselassie back in 2008. At this point, I was completely spent from running. I had already run 11 laps at ascending pace to get to the final lap, which for me was unfortunately the fastest. In order to complete this workout successfully, I now had to run this final lap in 1 minute 9.19 seconds, which is the world record marathon pace of the great Eliud Kipchoge. Even though my legs were weak and my lungs were burning, I soldiered on for one final lap.
What happened? How'd it go? How'd it go? What'd you get?
70.
Oh no, you were one off.
Although I came up just a little bit short on my final interval, this honestly was a fantastic workout, and it really did give me a new appreciation for just how fast world-class marathoners really are. It's also a very unique way to see the marathon improvements over the past 100 years, as I started at 6 minutes and 41 seconds per mile and ended at 4 minutes and 38 seconds. And now I pass this challenge off to you. If you film this workout and you get all the way through, I'll make sure to share your video on this channel. Also, don't forget, you can pick any runner throughout each decade. I just chose these runners because I knew about them previously. Thank you all so much for watching, and I'll see you all in the next video.